Heavenly Father, we come before you this morning, dear Lord. As we have to go through the lesson for the real time, dear Father, may you guide us. In Jesus' name I pray and believe. Amen. We are starting our lesson today. Our lesson today is the last lesson of the quarter. And the topic of our lesson today is You a Hero. Who is a hero? You want to see how you can be a hero in the Lord, and how you can change the world, and how the world can change because of you. When the word hero comes into your mind, the word hero is a person in layman's language, you can say is a person noted for special achievement in a particular field. So we can have several fields. As Christians, we have several fields where we can excel. Most of the time when we think of heroes, there are people we think of, like people who have excelled in athletics, there are people who have excelled in football, there are people who have excelled in politics and other areas. But as Christians, as a hero, we want to look at three major pillars of excellence. One of them is people who believe in God's word. Number two, those who commit to do God's will, and also those who are devoted to do God's work. In the church, we have several fields where we can do God's work. For example, we have even somebody who can sing very well in the church, somebody who can excel maybe in playing piano, somebody who can do well in preaching, and also in giving. But how do we do this to serve God? How do people benefit from them? When you excel in this field of categories, other people can benefit from them. It can also change other people's style of life, living. It can also lead a more satisfactory life for individual. Let's look from the book of Matthew chapter 5 verse 16. But the book of Matthew chapter 5 verse 16 tells us that in the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. So when you do things which are good, you shine in the village, you shine in the community, you shine to everybody, and then their lives will change, and other people also will benefit from what you are doing. From the book of Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11 to 16 tells us that Ephesians chapter 4, verse 16 says that it was He who gave some to be apostles, some to be prophets, some to be evangelists, and some to be pastors and teachers. So we can do all this, but everybody has got his area of his area of professionalism, his area of excellence. If you are given the talent of prophecy, you are given the talent as a teacher, you are given a talent as a pastor and as an evangelist, then these people, other people in the community, will benefit from all these kind of the areas of excellence. Our lesson tells us that to be a hero of any kind, and the world will surely take notice. Be a hero and an agent of God, and both the earth and the heaven will take notice. When you are a hero of God, when you tell you are an agent of God, both the heaven and the earth will take notice of it. In the book of Hebrews chapter 11, sorry, in the book of Acts chapter 13 verse 22, the Bible tells us that I have found David, son of Jesse, a man after my own heart, he will do everything I want him to do. God is so much pleased with David, and that's why he chose David as a king at the tender age, and he's pleased with him. How can God be pleased with you? Because at this age of where we are now, how can God be pleased with us? What do we do that God? How can we be courageous and serve the God and serve the Lord so that He can be pleased with what you are doing? Because at this time in school and at home, sometimes we shy away from serving God because of our friends who may laugh at us, who may shy away from us. But we should be courageous enough so that God can uplift us, and whatever we do can change the world, can change the living of other people. As we are concluding for the lesson, I'm just asking all of us to be friends, to be courageous, and be heroes of God, so that when we serve Him, other people can also see what we are doing, and can also change our lives for the other people in the community, and above all, it can give praise to the name of the Lord. I'm ending the lesson from there, and before I end the lesson, I'm just asking if you maybe we can have a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, as we take to our talents, give our thought, Lord, may our talents have an impact in other people's lives, and we wish to be seen as the lights of the world, and we can change the world, and everybody can see that we are truly sons and daughters of God. In Jesus' name, I pray.